the Big Slice Music Show here on That's Manchester TV. This evening, I am in the bosom of Manchester in the Northern Quarter. I am joined by the transmitters. Please get in touch with the show before these guys go absolutely crazy. They're too cool, these guys. Get in touch with the show, hashtag That's TV at Slice Music Show on Twitter. We've just been part of the Last Race Home double A-side EP launch at the 3 Minute Theatre. Gentlemen, for an absolute beautiful evening of great music, do us a favour though, for the viewers out there, let us know what you do in the band and what you do and what you're all about.
What our names are as well.
Yeah, not about flying pigeons, because we had flying pigeons off camera. So what you do in the band and what you're all about?
I play drums and I do backing vocals for the transmitters, and my name is Danny Short.
My name's Martin, I'm a trainee pilot and my favourite colour's blue.
Blue? I like blue. Blue's a good colour.
My name's Tony Dallas, I play bass guitar.
Tambourine boy.
Well, you're the front man tambourine boy.
Yeah.
So you guys are a Bolton-based band, but you've got a real thread of kind of the mods theme. You can see that in your branding. Is that where you guys are with your sound? Is that kind of the way you want to move your music forward?
We're better than that. Yeah, yeah. English rock, it's all in there. Martin will give you a lovely little synopsis of where we are in the mod scene, actually. Go on, Martin. You got it off to
Martin, do us a favour, because you've been dying to talk on camera. We've had talk of pigeons this evening.
Yeah.
But give us a talk about... Because the transmitters, to be honest, in such a short period of time, you've been catapulted forward, and there must be a thirst for that sort of music.
Yeah, but, I mean, what do you want from us? Do you know what I mean?
Me, personally.
I tell you what, it's all about marketing. You tell us what you want, we'll provide it. It's as simple as that. We're a mod band. Yes, we are a mod band. But we'll give you a bit of rock. We'll give you a bit of indie.
Yeah.
Just tell us what you want and we will provide it. It will have a mod edge, but it'll be the best mod edge you've ever heard.
Within reason, you know.
But to be honest though, it's like, you know, kind of, you do some original music, but you do a few covers there as well. Has there been a lack of that? Because you guys have just been massively pushed forward with what you do with your music, though, haven't you?
Well, from a covers point of view, we'll only do covers if we know we can do it right, because it's somebody's anniversary song in the audience. And I've seen too many bands now, because I love live music myself. If I'm not playing, I'm out there watching it. And there are too many bands get away with doing a cover, and they crucify it. And then they get paid for it on a Friday night. Now, that's not us. We prefer to hang on, let's do it nicely, put our edge to it. But the songs we write as well, you've got Dr. Feelgood in there, you've got Sid Barrett, you've got The Who, you've got The Faces, you've got The Kinks, you've got The Jam. There's not much more we can draw upon that it doesn't influence our tunes, because those are the best bands, there's no two ways about it.
Well, it's such a massive influence when you look at the mod scene and everything else. It's kind of such a big part of music.
Oh yeah.
How do you have your own identity in such a strong genre of music? Is that difficult to do?
No, because the tunes are cracking. Yeah. They're great tunes. And I was watching people in the audience tonight. I've got to be careful not to laugh when I'm on stage, because I'm so excited. Yeah. I want to laugh with the people in the audience and smile. They're enjoying themselves, and that's what we want to deliver.
Yeah,
in fact, I should have been taping. I should have had your camera from the stage tonight for us, and Last Race Home,
the audience, yeah.
And Dave and Broomhead, you know, Dave's.
Yeah.
Oh, wonderful. They weren't expecting a mod band, a rock band tonight, but they got one. But to see how they enjoyed that just encourages us to write those tunes in a similar vein as well. You know, there's no slouchiness. It's all pretty much... If you're going to come out and want to be entertained, the transmitters will entertain you. We'll get you dancing, we'll get you singing, we'll get you moving your arms.
So you're not falling into a groove of going, this is the genre, but you're kind of still exciting people with the sort of music you're doing.
Yeah, there's very much a rock element to it. And how many people have said tonight, it's quite interesting, people have said it time and time again, if you were a band doing what you're doing now, 35 years ago, you'd be massive. Well, I'm massive in Stalybridge. The lads are massive in Bolton.
Everyone's massive.
But we realise that it's a lovely compliment to receive.
So, I mean, it has been quite a short period of time, though, that you guys have been together in music, to be honest.
Well, me and Danny, we've been mates and band members in Bernie's other bands.
For the last 40 years.
40 years 40? Or so.
You don't look a day over 30.
Well, you know, it feels like 40 years. So we've been together for quite a while. And I keep saying to Danny, oh, we need to bring back that song that you wrote back in, you know, 1972.
Yeah. Yeah.
And, you know, maybe we will do one day. I mean, in the past, we've had miner strikes, we've had power cuts, we've had mass unemployment, we've had all sorts of malarkey going on, and other bands have written about that. Mm. And we've got stuff going on. I mean, what's happening at the moment with politics and all sorts? Yeah. If it wasn't for that, we wouldn't have lyrics. We're a working-class band, and we're writing working-class lyrics for the working-class man. We're not writing anything about right-wing this and right-wing that. And we don't want to be a political band, but there's so much there to draw on that we can just write and write and write, and it's easy.
Yeah.
You know, you've got U-Tree and all sorts, and we don't want to say too much about that, but we've, you know, we've got lyrics.
It's a Sunday show, so we need to be careful.
You know what I mean? What are we talking about?
So, people are getting ready for the bed and the cocoa, to be
fair. Well, yeah, well, you know.
We are.
Good. Go to bed. Enjoy your cocoa and go to bed.
Okay, so I mean, you guys are, you know, you're based in Bolton. Your music's fantastic. You lifted the roof in there tonight.
Thanks.
So I mean, you know, it's absolutely beautiful music.
It's worth mentioning that you're only really as good as your audience. And if the audience are with you, it gives you adrenaline. And I must mention the 3-minute theatre. Yeah. What a great venue.
Oh, yeah.
A great venue.
A great venue for a little intimate gig where you can get the audience on your side.
The people behind the scenes that have been helping out, sound and lighting and things like
pulling
that.
All together.
To say they put, you know, 4 acts on in the space of 3 hours, brilliant. We've already said we look forward to playing our own gig here with the Transmitters headline.
Yeah.
Might be one or two friends in there that want to support us, but we will play the 3-minute theatre without a doubt.
Oh, definitely, yeah.
When you've got a good audience, there's a good chemistry there. It's brilliant. When everything's going well and you're playing and then the audience is into what you're doing, it's like a ball being bounced back and forth. It's like, you know.
And you feel that kind of.
Yeah, you know, when the audience is with you, it encourages you to give more, and it when it clicks, it's nice. It is nice.
Okay, this is called Who Are You? Anymore.
you. You were the night. So tell me, how have we grown so old?
The recipe for you guys, can you guys, in no disrespect, you know, you're a bit older than the average, yeah, the age group in Manchester for music, and I mean that in a great respect, but your music shows that. I mean, you reflect kind of what you do tonight, yeah, and it's an absolute showpiece of great music. What's your recipe for kind of moving your music forward?
They're actually
bandages.
Band-aids.
Anesthetic.
Yeah. Yeah, but this is a backhanded compliment. There are actually a couple of bands that are on the scene, the so-called mod scene. They've approached us. They want to buy our songs. Wow. And they're under 25.
Not for sale.
There you go.
But so we know the songs are great. Of course they are. But at the same time, we love gigging live.
I mean, you see a lot of Manchester bands, you know, kind of just gigging and gigging and gigging. What's the recipe for you guys? What kind of, how do you move your music forward? Because you are influenced massively by the mod scene.
That's a great question, that.
Good question.
But because a lot of Manchester bands and artists and solo artists just gig and gig, and he's like there, every other day. What's the recipe for you guys? What's the kind of, how do you bring your music together in that sense?
We are quite selective, the gigs we do. We're all working, so we've got to fit that around the band. There's no denying that we'd love to be playing three nights a week and do the scene and the circuit and the other bands. I mean, I've seen some good mod bands turn into indie bands just to get a gig in Manchester.
Morphing into something else.
That's not us. We're not going to do that. We won't cross that line. We don't need to. And what we've realised is, yeah, it's nice to play Manchester, but we play all over the place. Yeah. And the credible gigs that some bands would take your arm off, supporting some of these big acts from back in the day, they're nice as well, but gigs like tonight, being so close to the audience and physically feeling the reaction, is gorgeous.
You know if it's working on that.
We've done arena gigs where the press pit and the security pit, it's 30 feet away from the stage, and we're playing 6 feet high. That's a long way to do anything.
Though, isn't it?
It is, absolutely.
It is, yeah. What's next for the Transmitters then?
New single we played tonight, which is just out, Weird Place. And we've got a new one which we played tonight, Smedders from Oldham Cron, is it?
He's a massive ambassador for new music.
Yeah, he's here tonight, and he loves You Need My Loving, which we're talking about bringing out as the next single, which puts us on nicer to the album. Album's nearly finished. That'll be out before the end of the year, all nicely polished. A few nice guests on that as well, which we'll keep quiet at the moment.
I think from my point of view, to move our music forward is just to get in front of more people.
Yeah.
And work
the
out.
The right people as well, though.
Yeah. Well, we've met some people tonight who don't know us and now like us and now going
to
follow us.
Happens
and
every gig.
Yeah, it's things like that. It's just more work, more gigs. Yeah.
Well, gentlemen, it's been an absolute pleasure tonight.
Cheers.
Where's the best place for people to find your music online, or what's the best place?
Facebook is the big one at the moment. Transmitters are on Facebook. Transmitters official.
Got a good following on that.
YouTube's getting there. YouTube's good.
Yeah.
We've not bought any of that following either.
No.
Again, one of the disappointments you see with a lot of media.
It's organic in that sense.
Yeah. The people that like the Transmitters because they've seen us and encouraged by other people to come out and check us out. Somebody asked for a photograph in there earlier. Brilliant. Wonderful for her to say. He's been told to find you tonight when we get home online. That's what we want.
That's what it's all about. That's the goal, though, isn't it?
Well, I mean, we never go home with our full set list. Every time, every gig we play, people pinch our set list, then they're coming over, can you sign that? Yeah.
It's like, that's so mine, you know, get off, I want that. Yeah. It's a nice backhanded compliment, that, absolutely.
It's a good place to be in it.
Yeah, and when you see, there are a few people here tonight that know us, and they've come for a number of reasons, but to see them singing your lyrics, we've only written some of these songs 6 months ago, 12 months ago, and they're singing that's
a good sign of good music.
That's beautiful, that, Paul, to be able to see that. Yeah,
I think I'd like to pay a compliment to Last Race Home, by the way, for inviting us here tonight.
And they, I've just said to Den as he walked in, we had a bit of a hug, and I said, that was gorgeous tonight, love that. And as I said to him last time I saw them live, you're a festival band. Can't wait to see you on some of these big festivals. But I did say, and don't forget, Paul, you might need someone to support you again.
True. That's very true.
Been in the studio with this recently. This one's called Sweet Denial.
Never know. Believe the words of stupid lies, they'll leave you on your own. But I know that you're the place that I call home. You said you'd never leave me, then you hung me out to dry. You promised me the earth, and then you said it was a lie. It's easy spitting hatred, sitting on your guilty throne. I hope it never splinters when they leave you on your own. But I know that you're the place I call home. Oh, sweet denial. Oh, sweet denial. Oh, sweet denial. But I know that I'm the place call home. Yes, I know that I'm the place. I know that I'm the place that you call home. I never meant to hurt you or get locked inside my head. I give the earth to save you from this tangled, twisted web. You say that you're a big girl and you'll make it on your own. I got no need to worry, my concerns are overblown. But I know that you're the place call home.
Die, yeah. wanna watch me fall, but you don't wanna wait your turn. You wanna live your life, well baby gonna die, yeah. Gonna die. Well baby gonna die, yeah. You just complicate yourself, living in and out of this concrete hell. You wanna live your life, well baby gonna die, yeah. Gonna die. Gonna die. Gonna die. Well, baby, gonna die. Yes, you will. You're going too fast.
Well, gentlemen, it's been an absolute pleasure. It's been a great set tonight. I really enjoyed you on stage. You absolutely owned it when you was up there. And hopefully we'll see you again soon.
Definitely.
Yeah, I hope to, yeah.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
These guys have been the Transmitters. This has been the Big Slice Music Show. I've been Paul Owen. There we go. I've been Paul Owen. This has been the Big Slice. See you soon.
Take it easy.